Monopoly means higher price, restricted output, difficulty of getting a connection due to expense, and sometimes also it means lower quality. But why are there so many monopoly problems in the water sector? There are some ways of getting water which are actually quite competitive. Imagine, for instance, walking to a well with a bucket, filling the bucket with water, and carrying the bucket back to your house. You could do it, your friend could do it, your sister could do it, you could hire people to do it for you. There might be many wells you could go to. There would be a lot of competition. The problem with this competition is that carrying water on your head back to your house and walking for maybe as much as 2 or 3 hours, that's extremely costly. So the competitive way of buying and selling water doesn't always work. What's the cheaper way of getting water to your house? Well, think about it. Running pipes into your home, you then go to the sink, you turn on the tap, the water comes out. It turns out that getting water through pipes is generally much cheaper than having to carry it on your head or carry it in a bucket using your hands. The pipes, however, also give rise to a monopoly problem, and that is it's very expensive to lay water pipes from a source going into people's homes. You can well imagine that we could have 2, 3, 4 different companies, each laying their own set of water pipes, and then you would have some degree of competition, but the problem then is that you would have to pay for 2, 3, 4 different sets of water pipes leading into the home. When the cost of the pipe is relatively high, relative to what's being put through the pipe, we then say there are high fixed costs, and having then competition turns out to be relatively costly. And once you decide there's going to be only one main set of pipes running to a home, then you're back to monopoly problems. Even if you can arrange that 4 or 5 different sellers of water are selling their water through those pipes, the person or institution who owns and controls those pipes still has a considerable degree of influence over the market. It's very much the same kind of problem we see with electricity, that is a relatively high cost of putting up the wires and relatively low cost of transmitting the electricity on the wires, or for that matter, cable television. The real cost there is putting the so-called piping, the cable TV hookups to the homes, and the actual cost of transmitting the programs is low. So the general point is this, when you have high fixed costs, which come from something like piping, it's much harder to have competition in the provision of a good or service.